So thank you for coming. I will talk about a tool that I have created personally to manage and fix code conventions. Just a little bit of me. I'm working in a startup company that is called Sparsity Technologies, that is a spin-off of the UPC. I'm currently the technical lead of this tool. And well, in my free time, I also am writing some Docker articles in Java Code Geeks. And I have some research publication about UML and OCL that are modeling languages for formal software specifications. So, well, as you know, if we have a lot of lines of code, we have even more errors. So it's pretty obvious. And that's why we try to do the same things with less code. But what happens with the legacy code? We become completely stressed when we need to deal with maintaining this kind of code, and we don't know how much is the quality or how to measure this quality. In fact, for this reason, there are some quality code, static code analysis tools, also open source, like PMD, checkstyle, findbugs, that are executed locally, and also SonarQube, that allows us to get pretty reports about the results of these tools that give us how many issues we have in our legacy code. But then, what is the reason when we analyze our legacy code with these tools? It's like this one. This is the Maven project. The result of analyzing the Maven project with SonarQube. And the result is that we have more than 1,000 issues. And well, what is the last execution for these rules? Maybe 5 years ago. And our reaction, what is? I think that this one. We decide that maybe we should continue. It works. Why we need to change this code? And well, if SonarQube has told us that we need 75 days to clean all these issues, someday it will be fixed. Or not. But some developers, having their awareness of the don't repeat yourself principle, said, okay, there are some issues that we can fix, we should be able to fix automatically, because are very obvious, like cleaning imports, right? So that's the result. Some of us has written the same question in the Stack Overflow or on other places to ask for a script to solve these SonarQube issues that worries a lot of us. And that's the reason why we have created Walkmod. Walkmod is an open source tool that allows to apply code transformations. And one motivation for these transformations is to solve existing issues that a static code analysis tool has reported us. But also, it's more powerful than that. And we can define how we would like to generate all code from the minimum part that we have, for example, our domain model. Every company has their own programming practices. For example, the DAO layer, or the business layer, the REST layer, and there is a lot of parts that sometimes all of us, we have thought about why not generating this part of code. So Walmod is designed to promote this kind of conventions that every company has and reduce the amount of time that we need to do for the things that we need to do over and over again. Moreover, there are some critical situations where we discover that we need to apply a migration from one library to another, especially when we are dealing with no SQL solutions like Cassandra or Hadoop. And there are some minimal differences between one version and another. So why not automatize these parts? So we can do that with this tool. And well, that's not at all. It's open source, like the previous one. And the reason is that we want that companies collaborate to improve it and report their own code conventions and then make the life easier off altogether. And it's a tool that is independent from our editors. So we can run it from EI, Eclipse, IntelliJ, whatever. And it helps for especially for teams that contributes in projects that are around the world, and you can't say you need to use IntelliJ because every one of us has decided to use this tool. Top level convention. But there is not easy to build this kind of tools. And the reasons are several, but if we should summarize this in a little list, these are the most important ones. The first point is that modifying code, respecting the formatting, the existing formatting of every single source file is complicated. And in most of the cases, companies don't have a formatting style, although with Eclipse or whatever. The code has started in a given format, and the contributors has continued in their own way. And an example of this is WAVA. The WAVA project that is from Google, and Google is one of the most important companies that promotes the code convention, and they have their own ones. Doesn't have the same format for all their own code files, their own source files in the WAVA project. And also, what is the next difficult part? The false positives. If you have experience with SonarQube, TechStyle, or PMD, probably you are familiar with this word. That means that, well, they prefer to say, maybe you have an issue, than don't say nothing. And in some cases, these issues are false, and not really issues. And the main reason about this is because these tools doesn't take care of the class part of the project, and they are not able to analyze every single expression of our code. So, for example, they are not able to know which classes are using a specific method or a field. Another feature of Walmart is that it's a pluggable architecture. So it means that, well, if your company has your own kind of common issues that you should solve over and over again, you can create a plugin. The community can say your plugin, and all of us can use it during the next day. And every single update that a plugin contains is completely visible for the users in the next day after deploying it. So we will show you how Walmod works with the Google WAVA project, because I think that it's a very common project that all of us has used in some of our projects. So, okay. Walmod is a command line tool, so we need to create a configuration about our conventions, and the most important commands are these ones. The first one is to discover the list of plugins that are available to use. So there are code transformations that we can apply to fix some issues. The other, Walmod inspect and plugin ID, help us to discover the components that appear in a given plugin, because not everything are code transformations. We can redefine some components of the Walmod architecture. And, well, in fact, the most important two commands are the last ones. Walmod add, which puts a given code convention for our project, and Walmod apply, or check, that executes Walmod with the related specific with the regarding code transformations. Let me show you. It is connected to the mother repository, and this are the current Maven plugins. The most used are the check style, obviously, PMD, and SonarQube. And if we run Walmod inspect and the plugin ID like this, it downloads the jar of this plugin, and when it's ready, we get here. I don't think if the resolution is good enough, but well, we have here some of the most common SonarQube rules that can be fixed directly with these transformations. I don't know if I can do that. We will see after with more attention what these commands mean, but basically it's for setting what is our source directory and where is the directory where we want to put the code changes. Because maybe it's the same, or maybe we want to compare and put the results in another place. And there are different writers. Why? One writer, the default one, applies an equation formatter style. But as I have told you before, you can decide to use a given writer that respects your programming style. But in the future, for example, it could be a writer to apply the IntelliJ formatter. So it's just an option that allows you to get a lot of flexibility. And also we have exclude and include rules that can be applied directly over our source directory. So let's put this command on the WABA project and see what happens. I have decided to use the rule of assuring that if we are compiling two strings, and one of them is hard-coded, the hard-coded one should be the implicit object, and the other one is the parameter. And the reason is because obviously the not hard-coded one could be null, so the project could launch a null pointer exception. So okay, in that project that it's Maven, the default source directory is not source main Java, and that's the reason why we should specify source as the file, the folder of the source directory. And we will use the string writer that is the one that respects our formatting style. So let's play. So the WABA project is the fresh version because is on June 16th. There's nothing here. And the role was Sonar. It will create a configuration file with this rule. I don't know what the connection is working for. Strange. So the result is that now we have a Walmod XML file. With this transformation, so let's continue. Walmod set. We check again the configuration file. We have the apply change here. Sorry, there is something wrong. There's something wrong here. The comment that I have written. Sorry. So these are the modified files by Walmod. If we run Git, we will check that the change is applied like I have described, because the hardcoded string, in that case two dots, are moved in the implicit object instead of the argument. Right? Can you see it well or? Okay. And, well, we can add more information, like, for example, we want to remove all the unused imports, unused classes, methods. Private, obviously, because we don't want to get problems. Taking into account that in order to execute Walmod compiles a project with Maven or Gradle, depending on your on building tool, because it the tool requires your class files. Add what? Sorry. The name is wrong. Just to be sure. Is the code pulling that? Is the code pulling, sorry. This one. this transformation takes a little bit more, but we will take here and we will continue to save time. So at the end, when the transformation finishes, that takes a little bit, we have processed more than 500 of bytes in, well, 100 seconds. That this is the most complex transformation, because every time we remove one method, we need to analyze if the other, well, it's a chain process. So if we remove one method, we need to analyze if the calling method also needs to be removed, because it's a less reference. So probably we take a cascade of changes. So it's the most long transformation and takes this amount of time. So how it works? Mainly there are different execution blocks, and these blocks are called chains. And in each chain, there is a pipeline of code transformations. And the process is as follows. First of all, we need to parse the source code, and then we need to produce an equivalent structure of the content of the file. So it's commonly known as the abstract syntax tree, the compiler's area, if you are familiar with this. After that, Walkmod applies a semantic analysis, that is the key point in contrast with the other tools, that resolve who calls who and who uses who, using the bytecode. And then, after this, you run the pipeline of code transformation that you have specified, and finally write dumps the content of this Java object that represents your source code into the same file or different, depending on the output directory that you have specified. Let's understand a little bit more all this stuff. For example, imagine that you have this string that represents your source code. It could be the content of a simple Java file. So the parsing process of generating the abstract syntax tree is as easy as calling this library that originally comes from the Java parser project that is open source, but we have improved it supporting Java 8. And then, after that, we are able to write conditionals or modifications over this object in our code transformations. Okay? And, well, once the source code is parsed, we need to analyze in order to resolve what are the real Java classes or Java methods that we are using in our source file, because all that we have is a Java object that represents what we have in our source file. So, okay, and what does it mean that we are able to give to the developer the resolution of the reflection element equivalent of every single part of all the expressions that appears in the source code, and then the developer are able to create transformations like I want to add the overwrite annotation if it's needed, because we are able to analyze by reflection if this class is a subclass of another one and this method already exists on the parent element. In other words, the semantic analysis allows to recognize what are the definition elements, methods, fields, classes, and where are they used. And this capability gives us the power to apply refactorings in an automatic way. It's not a little way, but this is the associated API to control this kind of things when we are writing code transformations. The first one, get symbol data, gives us the element that has inside the JavaLang class or the JavaLang method that is representing our source code element. We are able to get the full list of usages. In case of being a node and a reference, where is the definition? So it's the opposite direction. And in a scope, that is a block of statements or another definition, we are able to resolve what are the variables, type, and other stuff that appears declarated inside this element. And a plain refactoring is as easy as using the rename operation in case of fields. So there is a plugin, available plugin to apply migrations. And if we put rules like this one in a JSON format, we are able to refactorize all the projects according to these rules. And then we are able to apply the definition changes and also the references. And in case of creating rules that needs to not only modify a given source file, not all their references in the project, we need to use this API. With the passing this element, that is the transformation. So, in conclusion, the semantic analysis benefits that has one in contact with other tools is that we don't want false positives, because otherwise we are modifying in an incorrect way the source code. So we don't want to have a basic semantic analysis. And well, it allows us to get a powerful transformation to reduce the technical debt with removing the code, for example, resolving class hierarchies, the typical operations that we are using in our editors. And how we write code transformations. In case of requiring semantic analysis, we need to put the annotation on top of our class. And then extends from void visitor adapter. If you, I'm not sure if you know the visitor pattern, but the visitor pattern allows us to separate the behavior of the object and applies an operation for each kind of different object in a huge hierarchy. That is a typical case of after syntax tree. It's a common well practice in that
world.
So then we need to define a visit operation for each element that we want to change or analyze. That could be a method in this case or a field. And well, there are two parts. We can call to the superclass that continues with the analysis of the part of this node, or otherwise we can only analyze some children element of our node, that in this case we need to call the accept method of the node that recursively will call the visitor class. And how we can test these code transformations? Well, we need to extend the semantic test class. And it gives us an API to compile a given string that represents our code into a class file, and then we are able to get the semantic analysis compiled result after calling the compile method. And then, for example, we can invoke directly our transformation that is our visitor. In this case, it's a visitor that modifies if we are comparing the size of a collection with zero and replacing it to is empty. And then check with the elements of the abstract syntax tree with the element that we expect. I don't know if it's too hard because there are many complex concepts behind this project. And well, the last part is applying the changes that we have made into the abstract syntax tree. That, well, the default one is the Eclipse formatter that has a default configuration that we provide with the tool, but you can set your own. or the string writer, that is the thing that we have used in the WABA project, that only modifies the associative part in the code. Every writer has their benefits and their drawbacks. And okay, after having a code transformation or visitor, what's the next step? The next step is to create a plugin with our visitor. And it consists to create a project, as a project that we already have, with a plugin descriptor, that is a string configuration, because assigns an alias for a given class, that is our code transformation. And well, this descriptor should be Walmod, or name of the element that we have created, or the plugin name, followed by plugin.xml. And then, if we are completely, for example, adding some new rules to the Walmod Sonar plugin, in this case, we only need to add our code information in this plugin descriptor and create a pull request to submit these changes. Otherwise, you need to deploy yourself, your own plugin, into the Maven official Maven repository. So, well, this is another SonarQube rule. In this case, is to avoid redundant casts. So, as you probably know, you think it's very easy to solve it. So why not automatize this kind of changes and reduce our technical debt in one day? Well, so let's see how is the code of this rule. Well, execution has finished the previous execution of the WABA, so if we run git, we have some imports and university fields removed. And that's our private class that already is not used. And the previous changes. This transformation is as easy as it seems, because it's a simple visit method over the cast expression, and we only want to check if the type of the assigned of the resolved expression associated to the cast is the same type that we are casting. In that case, we need to remove the cast expression, right? So, to remove the cast expression, we are using the replies child node in the parent node, because we are saying that, well, instead of using the cast expression node, use the other part, right? And the associated test to that is like I have described here. We have the compilation unit that we are casting an object that already has this type, and in this case, the same. So if we run this test, everything is working, and one important part is that every single element of the AST, if we apply a two-string method, we have the equivalent representation in the original source code of this element. So it's easy to analyze what's happening. So, okay, maybe we have applied some bug fixing of, or we have created a new plugin and we want to test it before obviously deploy it into production. So what, in the case of, for example, adding a new SonarQube rule, what we need to do to test if it works with an existing source code base? We only need to fill the jar and replace it into the EB directory, because Walmod internally uses EB to resolve all the plugin dependencies. So it's as easy as replace the existing jar file of the Walmod Sonar plugin for the old one. And an important point is that, like Maven, Walmod has a command that is Walmod debug that allows us to perform a remote debug and then see what is happening for every single class or file that the tool is processing in that moment. So there are a lot of things to do, even we have a lot of work. But what are the most interesting features that the users have asked for? A complete incremental execution, because we want that not only Walmod applies modification over a given set of source files that are the last one that we have modified and it's existing in our repository, but also only in the part that we have modified. Another one, well, this first one was especially reported by the JBCNConf project, because otherwise they have classes very long and they don't want to get changes that are in a part that they have not changed. And well, as you have seen, you run Walmod and you have all the applied changes, but you don't know why these changes are applied, even we have the complete idea about the code transformation that we have introduced manually, specified. And well, after applying these modifications, people want to know why this modification is reported by which code transformation. And well, SonarQube has more than 1,000 of rules for Java projects, and we have, well, 20 of them. So probably there are other ones that could be useful for more people. So well, we need to work on that direction as well, but we hope that community helps a little bit. Finally, a full integration with the current editors, because well, the command line tool is for me is very easy, but as you already know, it's easy. It's even more easy to use it from the editor. So that's all for me. And if you have questions, comments, whatever, it's welcome. Yeah.
After running the code modification, have you seen any situation when you had some problems with performance or the code didn't improve the way that you wanted? So some tips or advice about this, so it always works as expected.
I don't know exactly what you mean. If you mean that, well, I have a modification that I don't want to apply,
yes. Or if you see some behavior, the result didn't improve the code like you are expecting.
Well, maybe, well, the users put the t- transformations that correspond exactly to a specific list of SonarQube rules. So they have, they can analyze easily if it is what they want. But having said that, sometimes, well, I have said that SonarQube has, like other tools, false positives. But also, what happens is that maybe there is a rule that says, well, if you have an utility class, that it is a class that all the methods are static, you need to have a private constructor, right? To avoid the bad practice of creating an object and invoke that method. You can apply this kind of transformations in a Spring Boot application, because if you apply this transformation, the Spring Boot application fails. Spring doesn't want that. So learning that, I have put this exception on the code transformation, but it's having these kind of things into account, because maybe the user wants to exclude that given set of files for this transformation and create a different execution block. But well, there are two approaches of this. But usually the problem is this one, that there are some frameworks like Spring or Lombok or whatever that expects a given structure of your class. If you are not aware of this and you apply a code transformation that different doesn't allow that, you can experiment problems in that way. So just you need to ensure and have the appropriate case for that. To do that, of course, it's because I don't have enough time to do everything. But well, I need to analyze what are the different ways to detect code duplication, which is the most efficient way, the one. But it's an interesting thing to add, of course. But the problem here is that in the case of code transformations, we need to improve one mod to ask for a question to the user, because in this case, what you want to do is create, for example, a new method. But this method, which is the most appropriate name for that? What is the most appropriate name of the method that you want to create? So the tool can infer these kind of things. We can suggest, but of course, nobody will like it. It's the tool. So, well, I think that a given step more is to get feedback from the user for this kind of things. Because, well, it's, yeah. Even if you have a complicated method and you can split it easily into different parts, what are the names of these parts? In fact, I have a rule that I would like. That I implemented recently, that it's about you have the same constant value as a string or a number in a class that appears multiple times. So you need to, if you want only have this value once as a field, what is the name? Yes, I have put level 1 if it does exist, or level 2, or level 3. But, well, I hope that, I think that at the end, the user needs to put the appropriate name for that.